So this is the experiment from which where we are measuring the surface roughness or surface flatness by using a monochromatic light source. This is one of the very precision method where we are going to get the flatness error in terms of the light source, that is a monochromatic light source, where here we are using optical flats. In that light band reading through the optical flats using monochromatic light. So that is what the source we are using here. Okay, so these are the optical flats. So see here, this is one of the optical flats, that is a flat surface, and this is made to be in conjunction with this slip gauges. Why we are using slip gauges? Because slip gauges are having a very flat surface and even a polished surface. Here, whatever the surfaces we are using, two surfaces, they should be polished to a very high accurate, that is a mirror finish. Okay. Here we are using three types of optical flats. This is made out of quartz. So this is a flat optical flat, this is convex, and this is concave. Okay. By using this, we are going to have a light bandwidth as well as dark bandwidth. Now, in this one, you see the basic principle is, so it is shown here. So let us see here, this is what the optical flat, and this is placed on the flat surface. Here we are differentiating the surfaces with the optical flats, right? For example, here the optical flats, if it is placed on the surface to be tested, it is going to make a wedge here. Just see here, one ray is entering here at A, and partly it is transmitted through AB, and partly it is reflected back in this one BC, and here this will go out of the optical flat. Okay, afterwards you see the same ray, some part is transmitted from B to D, and again D to E, and again E to F. If these two rays are in phase, a bright band will be seen. Again you see here one more ray is there, that is from G. The ray G is partly transmitted to H, and from there partly reflected back, it is HJ, and the same ray is partly transmitted to HK, and then again it will be reflected back. If these two rays are in out of phase, there will be dark bands are seen. So we are counting the dark band to measure the surface roughness. Here you see when the bright band will be seen and when the dark band will be seen. That is what the one of the concept here. The difference between the lengths of the paths taken by the two rays, BD plus DE, and if this distance is even number of half the wavelength, then the rays will be in phase and bright band will be seen. If the two rays, the difference, path difference between these two rays are odd number of half the wavelength of this particular monochromatic light, then they will be out of phase, then dark band will be seen. You see here, three different surfaces are shown here. This is a flat surface where we are going to get the fringes in the straight lines. They are very parallel to each other. Like the same way here, convex surface is there. We have made this as a convex, the optical flat, and here it is a concave. In the convex, you see, I will show it here clearly. You see, in the concave here, so at the center, there is no contact between the two surfaces. There is a bright band will be seen. Afterwards, it is followed by dark circles. So this is the convex, where at the center it will have a contact, it will be a dark band, and followed by circular dark bands. So convex and concave. You see, as here we are not using the larger surfaces, the surfaces will be like this way. So this is the optical flat below which we have used the slip gauge. And if you see from the top, this is the flat surface, straight surface, where the dark bands are seen like this way, parallel straight lines. And in this one, concave surface, the dark bands are seen in the curvature. As there is a very limited surface, we can't able to see the circles here. Here this is a convex, here also we are going to see curved lines. Okay. And by counting this dark fringes, and then, so we know the lambda of this particular monochromatic light, and multiplying number of fringes with lambda by 2, we are going to get the flatness error of this one. Now let us see here, this is what the lambda is, the wavelength of this monochromatic light source. It is a standard, okay, which is given by the designer. Okay, you see here, for the flat surface, flatness error is equal to, now let us see here, let us count the of number of dark fringes here. See, we have to adjust it so that we are going to get maximum number of fringes. Right, just see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 fringes are seen here. All the fringes are in straight line and they are parallel to each other. Now 7 into lambda by 2. Already I have written lambda by 2 here. 7 into that much. Now just point out that one. That will give you the flatness error. 0.0001847. 0.0001487 into 7. That is 0.0010409 mm, because lambda is given in mm. Now flatness error of concave surface. You see here, this is what the concave. So how many fringes are shown here? There 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 fringes are visible there. We have to multiply 5 into the lambda by 2, then we are going to get the flatness error 0.0001487 into 5. So that is 5.0007435 mm. Like the same way for convex surface, 1, 2, 3, 4 fringes are seen here, dark bands. So that is 4 into 0.0001487. That will be 4 into 0.0001487. So that is 0.0005948. 4.0005948 mm. This is the flatness error of convex surface. By this way, we can able to get the flatness error of different surfaces. So this is the tabular column where some students has done this one for straight surface or flat surface, and this is the concave, convex, number of fringes, flatness error is there. Remark on the surface, that's what I have written here. So this is what. So for this one, straight lines will be seen, and for this, the curved surfaces. Again, for this also, because as the surface is limited, we are going to see the dark bands only in this way only. So this is about a very simple way of getting the flatness error of different surfaces by using optical flats in conjunction with some good quality surfaces. That is, here we have taken slip gauges. Okay, thank you all.